too pompous for what it was. In fact, gates in general seem to do that. This one especially so. Red bricks, black wrought iron, and gray plaster. Similar to a home that didn't feel welcoming at all. I wondered if it looked like a gate for a school, looked like what a gate for a school should look like, but couldn't really decide. Probably no. Of course, I didn't want to get stuck thinking about that gate, the gate for too long, so I had to throw it with a brisk pace that felt surprisingly good. Moving forward feels good. So I walked towards the main building of Yamaku. I guess academy with this brisk pace. I'm alone as my parents are taking my stuff to the dorms. There's supposed to be someone waiting for me. The grounds are incredibly lush, filled with green. It doesn't feel like the kind of grounds a school would have, more like a park with a clean walkway going past trees and the smell of fresh cut grass and all other park-like things. Words like clean, hygienic pop into my mind. Makes me shudder. I shake them off. Stay open-minded now. It's a new life. You have to take it as it comes. That's what I tell myself. A few big buildings loom behind the leafy canopies. Too big and too many for just a school. Everything seems off. It's different from what I thought I knew about schools. It's an uncanny valley. Even though I was told this is my new school, in the back of my head it doesn't feel like one. I wonder if the feeling is real or caused by my expectations of a school for the disabled. Speaking of that, I don't see anyone else here. It's kind of eerie. It makes me wish there's somebody here so I can anchor myself to something tangible, instead of having this feeling that I step into another dimension. With the trees hum with the wind and the green hues flashing all around me catch my attention. It makes me think about hospitals again, how they said that the operating rooms are painted green because green is a calming color. So why am I feeling so anxious despite all this greenery? Only after I stand in front of the haughty main building, I surprise myself by realizing why the gate bothered me. It was the last chance I had to turn back, even if I had no life I could return to. But still, after entering, there was absolutely no way I could go back anymore. Feeling nervous, and with this realization set in my head, I opened the front door. A tall man with bad posture notices me as I enter. We're the only people in the lobby, so it's only logical. You must be Nakai. Nakai. So you are. Excellent. I'm your homeroom and science teacher. My name is Mewtwo. Whatever they like to call him. We exchange a handshake that is neither firm nor sloppy as he looks at his watch. Head nurse asked you for a brief check and visit, but there's no time for that now. Oh, should I go later? Yes, afternoon's probably fine. You should get going and introduce you to the rest of the class. They're waiting already. Waiting for me? I don't really like being the center of attention, but I guess it's inevitable in a situation like this. Somehow not knowing what is waiting for me makes me feel really nervous. Thinking of this, I must miss what the teacher is saying. Do you want to introduce yourself to the class? Yeah, of course. Yeah, sure. I mean, isn't that normal? Of course, but not everyone likes to be at the center of attention. I'm probably one of those people, but I guess I should be the one to give the first impression of myself. Right, but it's no problem. Let's go then. Heart's pounding in my chest, and keeps thinking about my condition as I follow the teacher up the stairs. Down the third floor corridor is marked as the classroom for class 33. Nita opens the door and enters. That picture, though. Just before we go any farther, look at that picture. Good morning, everyone. Sorry I'm late again. I sit for a split second in the door, freezing on the spot. Ah, get a grip. This is a big step. I know that, but there isn't any point to worrying so much about it. At least not this soon. Holy freaking Anime City. I follow the teacher into the classroom, look around, and parse this so I won't have to meet the curious gazes of my new classmates. The only one I remember is her. It is the black girl in the back that's holding her eyeball. I don't really think you meet anyone else here. It's not completely wrong. It's pretty spacious. ceiling is unusually high, and there's a lot of space left over around him and in between the desk. An entire wall taken up by blackboards and the high, old-fashioned windows only make it seem larger. Oops, sorry, I right-clicked. My bad. The students' desks are just standard wooden desk with a shelf underneath for books and wooden chairs with metal frames. Simple and efficient. Where's the shelf at? Oh, there it is. I think that's it. Stop walking in front of the classroom and face the students. They all look normal. Like students in the other school, but then why would they be here? Probably like me and have something wrong with them. Only it's just not immediately obvious. They notice that one of the girls seems to be missing the thumb of her right hand. It's a little jarring. Probably the natural tendency to listen when someone's talking about you. I tune out the teacher's speech halfway through while he introduces me to the class. There's a flash of dark hair and see that someone is looking at me. A girl with long hair that is pretty eye-catching. As she sees me looking back at her, she covers her face with her hands as if to make her invisible. There's one boy with a cane leaning against the lockers at the rear of the class. It's weird seeing someone so young with a cane. Another girl seems to be making some weird notions. This black chick next to the pink chick. Sign language? She peers at me over the rim of her glasses, then goes back to whatever she's doing. I remember both of these girls. She's kind of cute. So is the cheery looking girl with pink hair sitting next to her. She's really hard to miss. I don't know how I didn't notice that the moment I walked in. Please, welcome our newest classmate. The cops say so is everyone else. Except one girl in the first row has only one hand. I cringe a little behind it by bowing and thanks for the supplies I did not deserve. A collective sigh tells me that I should open my mouth now. So, I'm Hisao Nakai. And after that, my hobbies are reading and soccer. I hope to get along well with everyone, even though I'm a new student. And after that, I'm being so boring. This is exactly like every self-introduction ever. I should say something more exciting. I end up saying nothing. The teacher picks up from there. It seems to be satisfied even with what little I said, though. A few girls are whispering to each other, throwing glances at me. Could have gone worse. Triple dot. I listen to the teacher as he drones about getting along while letting my gaze sweep across the classroom. Everyone seems to be listening to him intently, and when he's done, I cup their hands again, which feels like a weird thing to do. The first row girl claps on this round with her one hand against the other wrist that ends in a bandaged stump. It makes me feel a little bad. We're going to do some group work today, so that'll give you a chance to talk with everyone. Is that okay with you? Yeah, it's fine with me. That's good. You can work with Hakamishi. She's the class representative. She can explain everything you might want to know. And who else would be able to do that better, right? How could I know? Did she pass up the daily assignments and announce that we'll be working groups of three? It hits me that I don't know who Hakamishi is. Slow. The teacher seems to catch my helpless expression. Oh, right. Hakamishi is right there. Shizune Hakamishi. As he calls out her name, the cute, bubbly-looking girl with bright pink hair and gold eyes waves her hands at me. I take a seat next to her by the window. Hey, I guess you're Hakamishi, right? It's nice to meet you. Ha 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 ha! What? I'm cut off guard by her laughter. Nice to meet you, too, but I'm not Hakamishi. I'm Misha. This is Hakamishi. Shichan. Giggling, Misha points to the girl next to her, the one I saw using sign language before. It looks like she has been staring at me this whole time. She nods once nonchalantly to show that she acknowledges my presence, only barely. She has short yet carefully kneaded brushed hair, a pair of oval-shaped glasses balanced on the tip of a dainty nose, and dark blue eyes that seem to alternate every few seconds between analytical and slightly bored. It's nice to meet you. Jimmy looks at Misha, who smiles and makes a few quick gestures with her hands. Hakamishi nods and makes a few gestures of her own. I seem to wonder if the teacher was messing with me, saying things like, you'll be able to talk to people, and who better to explain things to you. I can see you a little confused, right? Right? But I understand why you would think I was Shichan. Shichan is deaf, so I'm the person who translates things back and forth for her. I'm like an interpreter. She says it's nice to meet you, too. You're the new student, aren't you? Well, Shichan, of course he is. If he wasn't, he wouldn't have been standing up there for no reason, right? Right. Seems like a very interesting person, doesn't he? We knew there was going to be a new student. We didn't know you would be here today, so soon. Hisao, right?
Hisao?
Yep, it fits, doesn't it?
Did I see that? I'm just surprised. Never liked that name.
Oops.
I don't really see how.
It fits. You look just like I imagined. Ha 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 ha. Yeah, you look just like a Hisao.
I wonder why everything seems to think so.
Takemichi taps her fingers on the desk to get Misha's attention. They gesture back and forth to each other excited, their hands a blur. Misha seems a little overwhelmed. Ha ha ha. Sorry about that. She still wants you to know that she's the class rep, so if anything you need to know, you can feel free to ask her.
Do you like the school so far?
We can show you around a little if you haven't had the time to walk around and familiarize yourself with it.
He just summons with a hard word of it, making it stick out in an otherwise fluid translation.
Thanks, that would be pretty helpful.
Yeah, I just kind of came straight to class today.
That's no good. You should always try to learn as much as you can about where you're going before you go there. Not just school either.
Always, even if it's a trip to the convenience store, really, Shishan.
I wonder about where you're going. I guess I didn't bother to do that, or just didn't care enough to do so.
I didn't look forward to this, even if I committed myself to go on with it half-assedly.
But anyway, I don't see anything. Misha signs something that ends in a shrug.
What was that?
Seems like it was about me.
I feel like slumping over my seat.
Both of them are smiling, but that shrug unexpectedly deeply.
Look down.
Are you okay?
Don't take it the wrong way, please. I hate it when people are afraid to ask questions. That's how people learn things, by asking.
Asking for help is perfectly normal, as much as needing help.
Stop looking like you just failed a test.
Alright.
Ah, and another thing, you don't have to call Shishan something so formal like Hakimishi or class rep all the time. Just call her Shichan.
That blush, though.
Ah, okay, maybe that's too casual. Maybe Shizune would be more appropriate?
Yep, Shizune is fine.
Heh, okay, that'd be a lot easier for me.
I feel a lot more ease. Both of them seem so friendly.
I feel like an idiot for being so apprehensive, really.
Especially about Shizune.
Well, I assume it all would be all business.
Well, she just seems like that. Just less so, I guess.
Huh? Alright, we haven't even touched the assignment. We should start work now, or Shishan will get mad.
The time is also kind of long, so we should start now if we want to finish it before the end of class.
Wahaha! That too.
Shizune glares at the two of us and pays attention. I don't need to know sign language to understand that.
Okay, I get the message.
After class, we can take a walk around the grounds together. It's a nice day today, okay?
The song is actually very challenging to get through, combining aspects of being both difficult and unnecessarily long.
Still, we finished it a few minutes earlier than anyone else in the class. Despite our late start, Shizune and Misha are really capable.
They're quite different, though. The class rep is as calm and professional as she looks. While Misha is a lot more playful and girlish, not to mention a little more easily distracted.
To be honest, the two of them did most of the work. I feel guilty about it.
Clock tower bell rings, signaling the end of the period.
Time for lunch.